celebrated. I was about to say infamous, but I think celebrated is more appropriate. Charles Castleman. And many of his colleagues at the time, who happened to be my teachers in the Quick Quartet, said, oh, you'll have a brilliant time. There's such incredible intellectual rigor. There is a great emphasis on practicing. You'll learn more than you ever will in your life. And indeed, all of that took place. What I was not told was that, among other things, I would serve time on death row, along with other miscreants like Richard Ruth, now one of the concertmasters of Orpheus, Steve Tenenbaum from the Orion Quartet, all for having missed curfew on a few nights. Charlie would assist people in barricading the door to my room so I couldn't get out at any time during the day. I often found peanut butter in my shoes. That was great fun. But above all, we had an amazing time certainly living Charlie's other spirit, which all of you know is a wolf. Now, I had contacted the retired police chief of Troy, New York, and he was happy to report that indeed the records remain of summer students at the Emma Willard School in Troy, New York, where the quartet program is held, being led by some furtive individual through cemeteries in Troy on the evenings of the full moon and howling. Well, let's just say that all of us have been lucky to experience both the brilliance and the hilarity of Charles Castleman here at the Eastman School for many, many years. And it indeed, it is with that fervor, affection, and humor that we're presenting this afternoon's program. Now, of course, nothing would be complete without some tributes. And I wanted to say, first of all, to Charlie, whom I think I can see here, thank you, that, of course, they have poured in, and as you can imagine, they're all absolutely superlative. However, Charlie, I can't explain. I think it's an acquaintance of yours who's possibly serving time at a federal prison, and there's a box backstage. I declined to open it. I'll leave it for you. I must also say that on behalf of Dean Jamie Rossi, he extends his very sincere regrets. He was hoping to be here, but his flight from Cincinnati was canceled, and so he sends outpourings of warmest affection and congratulations to Charlie on this day. I would also like to say that I had contacted the poet laureate of the United States, Charles Wright, who didn't know that Charlie went to Harvard, I thought, you know. But once he inquired as to what might happen in this program, he declined to write anything. But Charlie's friends are a true and steadfast lot. They are, come on. And surely we have a remarkable voice poet right here in our fair city, and that is the most wonderful and mellifluous voice of WXXI, the renowned Julia Figueras. Julia, please join me.
Thank you so much. I wrote a little poem for Charlie. I'd like to share it with you today. There once was a fiddler named Charlie who wanted to ride a big Harley. But as chances he blew, so a bike had to do. Though on it he looked rather gnarly.
Hannah Hurwitz, Sarasate, Vianyasky, Shinichi Suzuki. I think Charles Castleman has some finger in it, and for some weird reason, so does Maurice Ravel. But let's get started here. So, two of Charlie's brilliant young students will now perform a recognizable piece for you. They are Nicole, Oswald, and Marco Chow. Please welcome them.
Thank you.
so many of my colleagues in my department feel as I do about our colleague Charlie. And one of my beloved and much revered colleagues is Oleh Krysa, who, with his brilliant student Ji-Yeon Lee, is going to give you a side of Alfred Schinttke that you have never seen. So, please welcome on stage Oleh Krysa and Ji-Yeon Lee. Search committee, just one person, and I know the chair of the committee very well. His name is Oleh Krysa. Well, moving on from that, you're now going to be treated to two more of Charlie's wonderful students, Miclen LaiPang and Andrew Chalam, performing along with the wonderful pianist Laurina Hong, Shostakovich, Waltz, Prelude, Waltz, and Polka from his suite for five pieces. I think Andrew is feeling as though this is particularly his afternoon, since in fact for the past week when we had screen juries, he was incorrectly identified on every program, not as Andrew Dunlap, but as Andrew Dunlap. So regardless of that, please join me in welcoming these great artists on stage, and following Shostakovich, there will be a brief 10-minute intermission. Thank you. also might want to hear, and that was about jukebox night. Well, in fact, it required no quarters, and it really wasn't the jukebox, because the jukebox was Charlie. And he played on request. And this was usually before curfew was enforced, or else we went out howling at the moon. But it was really quite remarkable, because at the drop of a hat, what would pop out but Paganini modo perpetuo, or in fact, the work that you are about to hear, E Palpiti, Wieniawski F sharp minor, on and on and on and on, seemingly without stop, until curfew might be enforced. So, the curfew is not going to be enforced, and that means that we can now welcome on stage Miclen LaiPang and Cory Chang in Paganini's E Palpiti.
Thank you. Thank you. It was so good, I think I got canceled.
That boy has fingers, doesn't he? Professor George Taylor will be doing this afternoon, will be giving a most serious explanation of the dilemma involved for a young person in making this most critical choice about their musical pathway. He has chosen to do so with a piece some of you may know, the Ysaye Sonata No. 2, known as the Obsession. Please welcome on stage Professor George Taylor.
Thank you. The next piece, I'm very excited to introduce the extraordinary and one and only Laura Bossert on violin, and Charlie's longtime friend and acquaintance from the back streets of Barcelona, Don Jose Bernardo DeMarco.
Thank you. luck because I really need your help. Would you mind holding this?
Sure.
I know it's not what you usually write, but you know, you have to do. The Eastman bike team asked me to present you with a special limerick ode to Charlie, which we could not have done without the essential help of the Sibley Library McCrazy reference section for lyrical inspiration. Charlie is the coolest of cats. To him we take off our hats. To him we take off our hats. You see, we're all really shocked. I start over. Charlie is the coolest of cats. To him we take off our hats. He can fiddle with ease in all 24 keys, but while biking avoids sharps and flats. His students adore his style, his colleagues admire the guile that makes his strat sing and tugs at heartstrings, performed with that Castleman smile. As smoothly as he handles the bow, he pedals through rain and through snow. He has earned his success, and we wish him the best. Happy coasting wherever you go.
So yes, there we go, that's better. Charlie, this is for you. It has been somewhat rewritten. Apologies to Freddie Mercury and Queen. this is something that you're most deserving of. Bicycle, as arranged by Miclen and the gang. So.
He wants to ride his bicycle.
strapped on tight. He was skip in the day. He could teach, he could play. Bunch of comb makes you hump. And his fees I can always send. Charlie, Freeman thought he's so hot. Under coffer, probably not. He now had crossed what we want. But before those certificates, journeys get inside. All you want to do is bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. He wants to buy his bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. We've seen him ride East Avenue through driving rain and snow. Competitors want to knock him off, but they are just too slowly. Miami is coming your way, so just give them perception. Oh yeah. But all of the string players wish you would stay, so we hope you like visitors. Oh yeah. On your marks, get set, go! But thank you all so much. It was so heartfelt and enjoyed it. It was so well done. Thank you. Our pleasure. And join the reception up in Kaminsky Promenade. Thank you so much.